Well, I'm gonna do a Star Wars or Star Trek one for a bit. So here we go. Let's see if there's any Trekkie friends out there, Star Trek fans. Options, tutorials, and this tune of the music. Let's go to new game. Let's do new game. I'm gonna be Kirk. Ashbold, clever, replace good, good, good. This sucks. Don't tell me these two go out of it. Oh. Cool.
It is your move, Captain. I'm aware of that, Mr. Spock.
Damn it!
Your choice was valid, Captain, but highly predictable.
Predictable?
Since when have I ever been predictable? That is precisely why the move was predictable, Captain.
Captain, we have received an emergency signal from a nearby space station. Please report to the bridge points.
Shall we finish the game later, or do you concede defeat? You should know me better than that by now, Spock. I never concede.
All right, here we go.
Binary star is making communications difficult, but the station appears to be in some sort of distress.
Check off readings.
They are operating on emergency power and are struggling to maintain altitude.
Cause?
Unknown, sir.
Captain, they have issued a request for immediate evacuation.
Then let's help them out. Mr. Scott, prepare transports.
I wouldn't recommend it, sir. Those stars are giving off too much interference. Unless we achieve manual lock, we might fry those little guys.
Then we'll get them out the old-fashioned way. Prepare my shuttle, meet me in the bay.
Aye, aye, sir.
Captain, in spite of your seemingly endless desire to stretch your legs, I must remind you that you are still a Starfleet captain. This is clearly a job that Mr. Scott and a few ensigns could handle.
But then I miss all the fun.
Sir, the more prudent choice would be to stay on the Enterprise and wait for a response to our hails.
No, you're right. Lieutenant O'Hara, any response to our hails?
None, sir.
Well, looks like I'm going.
Where's Spock?
Let's go.
Captain, I must insist.
You insist?
You know what, Mr. Spock, a change of scenery might do some good, Captain.
You come with me.
Your shuttle's ready, Captain. But do you think it's wise to go yourself? I'm sure me and some recruits could handle this.
Don't worry, Scotty. We'll be fine.
Always makes me nervous when he says that.
Into the shuttle. So we need to keep going. Okay.
Spock gets through that
one. This is awesome.
Approach at 5x6. Maintain minimal safe distance.
Affirmative, Enterprise. I'm picking up high levels of radiation from two binary stars.
The whole space station would have been fried by those two stars by now. What the hell are they doing out there?
Captain, the station appears to be outfitted with solar collectors, but they are unlike any I have ever encountered.
Mr. Sulu, do you have any clue what an experimental power station would be doing out here in the middle of the world?
Negative, Captain. Whatever they're doing, Starfleet doesn't have any record of it. Preparing for final approach.
Keep the engine running, Mr. Sulu. I don't think we plan on staying on that thing for too long.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
officer, where is the captain of this station?
This way. You must hurry.
Oh, oh. Oh.
Is this the fun you were afraid you were going to miss, Captain?
Right. We need to get everyone out of here right away.
Captain, we must find an alternate route.
Very perceptive, Mr. Spock.
Captain, we're picking up some strange readings. There appears to be some sort of anomaly.
We kind of have our hands full. Anything we need to worry about right now?
The readings are off the charts, but I don't think so.
Just keep an eye on it, Mr. Chekhov.
Aye, aye, sir.
Stuck in there. Let's get him out of there.
I believe the door can be hacked from this side.
No time to waste. Whenever you're ready, Spock.
Are unnecessary. Please proceed to the shuttle bay for immediate evacuation. Captain, I must mention that many of these crew members appear to be Vulcan.
Your point.
With 10,000 Vulcans remaining, I question the logic of placing them on any type of experimental power station.
I question putting anybody on this thing, Mr. Spock, Vulcan or not.
Agreed, sir.
Hey, Spock, you look like you need a hand.
Sir, we need to disable that laser arm.
one catastrophe at a time, Mr. Spock.
All right, we have some more.
That doesn't sound good.
That doesn't sound good.
I'm advised having looked at that scanner. No other way around, Spock. Clock's ticking. Captain Kirk of the USS Enterprise, we have a shuttle ready for your evacuation.
While we appreciate your assistance, our captain and many of our top scientists are trapped in the transporter room on the other side of the station. We cannot simply abandon them.
Any suggestions, Mr. Spock? If we were able to reach them, Mr. Scott may then be able to obtain a manual lock on our positions.
I'm afraid that may prove impossible. All interior passages are blocked.
The suits hold up out there?
With the solar shield failing, direct exposure would mean certain death.
Well, I hate certain death. Spock, let's try to avoid direct exposure.
Captain, I will offer whatever assistance I can on your communicator. But again, I fear that these efforts...
Yeah, we get it. Certain death. Any other words of advice?
Try to live long and prosper.
Ready, Spock. We should engage mag boots now, sir. The solar collector is failing. We must avoid direct exposure. As soon as get a belt off your back, get in the cover, Spock. Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates. Got it. Wait for it. Go now. Thank you.
Uncertain how much more exposure our suits can handle. Whose idea was this anyway? I believe it was yours, sir. Right. Lieutenant, we have reached the station's core. We seek whatever further assistance you can provide.
The only way forward is to shut down the core's rings. To do this, you will need to work together. One of you must scan the control console to stop the ring. This will allow the other person to engage the locking mechanism. Commander, I must warn you, a manual shutdown under these circumstances is highly risky.
Gotcha. Should split up. It's got to be the console that engages the break. I'll make the scan. Stop the ring. Spock, shoot the lock. Success, Captain. We must repeat the maneuver for the remaining rings. Split up in the scope. Now would be a good time to shoot the lock. It's moving again. When the ring is stopped, that ring is exposed. A phaser blast would release the mechanism. One of us has to stop it to expose the brain. Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the lock. Another one down. Just one more ring to go. Place this ball aboard.
stop, that ring is exposed.
Oh, man. I failed.
It's got to be cultural. Stop the wreck. Spock, shoot the lock. Success, Captain. We must repeat the maneuver for the remaining rings. We need to split up if this is going to work. Time to shoot the lock. Another one down. Just one more ring to go. When the ring is stopped, that ring is exposed.
Keep in mind, I've never done this on a medium.
We're through the core. Let's find that stranded crew. No cover. I believe we may be able to open those vents. Perhaps our face was warned. Worth a shot. The orcs, keep shooting out those vents. Get in the cover. Our attempt was successful. Success, Captain. Get in the cover.
Are stable.
Oh, yeah. That was ridiculous. I'm gonna have to start it until I hear.
Excuse me. I'm James Kirk, captain of the USS Enterprise. And you are?
I am in need of assistance, Captain.
T'Mar?
Mr. Spock, it is a relief to see you here.
T'Mar, in what way can we assist you?
Our station has experienced a complete loss of power. Our transporter functions are also unreliable. There does not appear to be a safe way to be found.
There's always a way. Scotty, you keep me a lock on me? I'll try, sir. What's going on down there, Captain? That was a wake-up call, Mr. Scott. I need you to work a little faster. On it, sir.
We should make our way to the transporter, Captain.
After you. So, how do you two know each other?
We were classmates back in Vulcan.
Just classmates.
I realize this may be difficult for you to understand, Captain, but on Vulcan, relationships between the sexes do not automatically apply into the past.
Another reason I'm glad I'm not a Vulcan.
Mm-hmm.
I'll go on your wall, Captain. Ready and waiting for transport. See, there's always a way. After you, Captain.
I will not leave this vessel until my crew is safely out of danger. As a captain yourself, I'm sure you would do the same.
I like this one.
There are a few that you do not like, Captain. But they're going to make
There it goes. There it goes. Everyone. Anti-gravity boots. Hey, why didn't we think of that?
The station's not going to hold.
We gotta get back to the shuttle. Run!
Take the spread!
The station's not going
to
hold.
We gotta get back to the shuttle. Run!
Keep moving! Keep moving! This can't be.
There is no time to stop.
The end.
No.
No time to watch the sunset. Run. Star Trek. Yeah. Alright, I think that was the prologue. But yeah, be the commander's partner. Well, that's okay. Now we're on the Enterprise. Oh. And it automatically saves, so
are you all right, Captain?
Definitely better now, thanks. Another one? What is it, Mr. Chekhov?
I think you need to see for yourself.
Our simple solar flare.
All right. So I'm going to end it here. 40 minutes in. Yeah.